Okay. Where were we? Right, I had backed off a bit. I think I'm actually gonna go across here and check this out. Oh, hello. Oh boy. I have one arrow. Ow, okay. Time to fight! No choice. Had to do something. What is going on out there? Look at that. Oh, ah. Meh. Where'd he go? Sounded like he fell. I think this is another ravine, but it's kind of hard to make sense out of what I'm seeing here. It just looks like a big jumble of bits of abandoned mines and stuff. But I shouldn't be seeing that much of, you know, an abandoned mine, even if it's exposed. Unless that's another big ravine, which it probably is. Oh, there's a chest down there. Why am I sneaking? I've been playing too much Skyrim. Oh, I can't believe I was trying to sneak. Man, this place sounds really hazardous. It's just non-stop racket going on, spiders and zombies and falling skeletons and walking. Aha! Oh my goodness, no wonder. Look at this place. This place is bad news. Wow. I picked a heck of a place to settle down. There's so many ways to die all in this one shot. This is the worst place ever to be hanging around. Or to be exploring from the bottom up. I really would rather be exploring from the top down. For reasons like this. No. 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 Okay. Yeah, it's a little bit busy up in here. Jeez. I don't even have the supplies to deal with something like this. To deal with a place like this. You know, oh, yep, see? Did you see that? Almost got the jump on me. I don't know what happened to him. But it sounds like there's more than one. A lot more than one. Okay, so I'm just gonna back off a bit from that direction for now. And I already explored a lot of this, didn't I? Dang, I heard a spider fall. I'm gonna get this iron here. Yeah, I got a lot of good stuff that I don't want to lose, so I don't want to try to engage that whole crazy ravine. Man, oh man. I think that makes like 5 ravines, because I think there was another one up in there. Like, there's 2 ravines that go at different angles away from each other. Oh hey, there's lapis in the ceiling. I didn't even notice that before. And I would also need a heck of a lot more torches. I only have these 48, so I'd have to go make some more. But let's take a peek at this side over here. If I don't find some exposed diamonds here, then I'm probably gonna give it up and... Oh yeah, I've already explored all that side. I should actually probably go ahead and try to shut that off. There we go. Yeah, if I don't find any exposed diamonds on this particular expedition, then I'm probably going to make a mini branch mine or something and just get it over with. And I'm clearly not going to be finding any. Okay, I've got everything organized away for now. So, I'm going to try... I'm just going to try getting diamonds more directly. Because clearly this strategy of trying to, you know, hopefully randomly find a diamond because it's easy is not at all working and has not at all proved to be easy. So, I'm going to... head down to the bedrock level or determine where the bedrock level is, and then I'm going to make a little start a little mini branch mining operation. Not a full blown one, just enough until I hopefully happen across some diamonds, and then it's enchantment time. Well, I popped out into that ravine I was exploring. Could explore it further. There's lapis. Come on, Minecraft, give me some diamonds. Give me some freaking diamonds. I think I need to explore this out right here. I'm going to, I'm gonna harvest some of this, because since there's so much good stuff right here, gather a bunch of it, and then I'm gonna go make some torches and come back. Takes care of that. There we go. Freaking diamonds, finally. Just gonna make sure it's safe here. Safe. Yeah. Not bad. What is that, 6 diamonds? I think it is. Getting the diamond achievement like I never got diamonds before. Or maybe, have I really not got diamonds since achievements came out? I suppose that's possible, but that seems like a really long time. Well, whatever the case, I got all the diamonds I need. So now, let's head back the way we came, right after we get this iron. Okay, and now I think the recipe goes like... something like this. Oh wait, not paper. What am I doing with the paper? I just had extra paper, didn't I? Oh yeah, yeah. Derp, derp, derp. 2 diamonds, and then a book. Yes. Enchantment table. There we go. And I need like an enchantment spot, but should be able to just plop down my table any old place now. I'm gonna put it right here. Ooh, look at that. That's really cool. And now I'm gonna have to figure out how to make this work. I assume you put something in here and then something happens that I don't understand quite yet. But before I do that, I'm gonna make sure that I have, you know, the library and whatever going and try to maximize the potential here. So I'm only gonna be able to make four bookshelves for now, which is probably not the optimal amount of bookshelves, but it's better than no bookshelves. So I'll just put these. Oh, look at that! Look at that! The book is reading books, apparently. So, I have expanded my reed farm just a little bit. I added three more rows to it. And man, reeds take a long time to grow. Holy heck. Ugh, really boring waiting for them to grow, so I'm going to find something else to do. You can also see that I've added some more shelves to my little enchantment zone. This is sort of my first attempt at it, so I'm just going to go in with a area right here, and then I'll probably transplant it somewhere else more permanent later. And I was thinking, I got tons of iron and such, so I'm going to try... Yeah, tons and tons of iron. I'm going to try enchanting just one iron pickaxe before I try, you know, doing anything with a diamond pickaxe or other tools, and see what happens. Because I have no experience with this at all. All I know is you put the table in the vicinity of your library stuff, and then you see the little magic stuff floating in there, Galactic Standard or whatever, and that lends power to the possible enchantments that you can do. So I'm going to try this for the first time. I've not even seen videos of it. I don't know what this looks like or anything. I just know you put the tool here, and then magic happens. Okay, so there's three different enchantment possibilities here. You can't see what they are. It's unreadable. Even if you translate it into standard alphabet, it's not. It's just gibberish, as far as I know. And then they're level 6, 6, and 8. And if you take it out and put it back, you get a different possible arrangement of things. And since you can't really know what you're getting, I don't see, you know... I suppose you could just keep doing it until you get a number of high-level things. I got two really high-level things here compared to the level 6, level 8 stuff that I was getting. I wonder if I should go with this one, but this one's level 4 or whatever this is. I'm just going to try it because I've not done anything. Oh, okay. Now I'm derp. I guess you have to pick one. That's the next step. I guess I'm going to go with the highest level one here. Okay, I now have a pink pickaxe. Unbreaking. So that means... Whoops. Oh, that doesn't count as a different kind of iron pickaxe. That's unfortunate. So unbreaking... What level was it? Level 2. I don't know what the max level is. It's probably 4. Some of them cap out lower than others, or so I've read. Unbreaking means that I can use this pickaxe longer, and it's less likely to break itself. I was going to try it, although unbreaking probably isn't exactly something where you can see it not breaking. Well, I guess actually I used it to break these two blocks here, and the durability didn't even show up until I got over here, so... I don't know how long it, how much more life that adds to the pickaxe, but probably pretty decently. If it doesn't count damage or durability for a certain amount of time over a regular iron pickaxe, then that's good. So I'm going to use this to dig out this wall here while I wait for the reeds to grow and get more library going. Kind of need to change away from caving and crafting for a bit anyway, so. Before I dig out the wall, I'm going to make that little change I was talking about to prevent creepers from being able to so easily jump my little wall there. Because it'd be really easy for them to just follow me where I can't see them above my head, and then as soon as I get to the right spot, they jump over and kick my butt, and I don't want that. So, how many slabs can I make here? I can make 12. I don't remember how big the gap is up there, so I'm going to make some more stone bricks. There we go. That should be plenty, 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 plenty. And I'm gonna put some temporary lighting in here. Talking about Minecraft.